Welcome back to another video in our dashboard series. Today, you'll dive into configuring the heat map gadget. You'll also learn how to interpret the information they provide. Let's get started. Heat map. This gadget creates a graphical representation of your data, where the individual values are represented as colors in a matrix format. It depicts values for a main variable of interest, normally the energy, across two axis variables as a grid of colored squares. The vertical axis displays the 24 hours of the day, starting at 1 a.m. at the bottom and ending at 12 a.m. at the top. The horizontal axis displays the days based on your selected time range. With a heat map chart, a user can analyze energy consumption by visually identifying high or low consumption periods, patterns, and trends. They can also use it to spot anomalies such as sudden spikes or drops in energy usage, which can indicate potential issues or inefficiencies. This can help in making informed decisions to optimize energy usage and improve overall efficiency. Gadget configuration. Let's walk through the process of configuring the gadget. To begin, you can either click on the plus button to add a new dashboard, or access the top menu and select Add a New Dashboard. Once the dashboard is named, proceed by clicking on Add Gadget. Next, navigate to the Usage Analysis category and select Heat Map. After providing a title for the gadget, such as Building Energy Usage, and choosing the desired level of opacity, proceed to the next step. At this stage, you have the option to customize the font, precision, and color, but for now, let's move on to adding the data series. This gadget supports hierarchies, allowing you to choose from individual devices or groups of hierarchies. In this case, I have configured a hierarchy, and I will take one of the areas to visualize its energy consumption. Remember, you can also customize the display name and units. Heat map is the type of gadget where you can only select one source measurement pair. Once selected, you need to go to the next step where you specify the time range. For instance, you can select last month. Finally, configure the details of your gadget. For colors configuration, select Use fixed value color ranges to manually define the color gradients by entering values into the boxes. Enter values based on the maximum expected consumption value per interval. If you clear the Use fixed value color ranges checkbox, then the gadget assigns colors for the heat map automatically. For outliers, select Remove outliers to exclude data values that exceed the max threshold or fall below the min threshold. Define the threshold values by entering limit values into the boxes. For heat map header, select Show data series name to display data series name at the top of the heat map chart. Select Show total to display a total value at the top of the heat map chart. For data gaps, select Clear last log after a data gap to exclude large interval values that are the result of data gaps from the displayed data set. Now, let's review the results. First, let's adjust the window size for better visualization. In this display, it's evident that there's a pattern of higher consumption between 3 a.m. and 7 a.m. from Monday to Thursday, compared to other hours and days. Additionally, there's a noticeable trend of lower consumption between 4 p.m. and 10 p.m. every day. Let's execute another example to identify anomalies. In this instance, the user can readily spot that on Tuesday at 9 p.m., there was an exceptional spike in energy consumption compared to the usual trend. Armed with this information, the user can conduct a more thorough investigation to uncover the cause of this anomaly. Before we conclude the video, Please remember that in order to utilize this gadget, your system requires the Energy Analysis Dashboards module license. Without it, the gadget will not be enabled. Thank you for watching.